Hey there, thank you so much for checking out this video. Today I'm going to show you how to play the song All Ends Well by Altabridge. I already covered this song, so if you are interested in my cover version, you can find the link in the description. But I have to say, I'm going to teach you today the original version. So I'm going to teach you how Mark and Miles played the song on the record. At the time I was making the cover version, I didn't know that, so I just figured it out by myself, and I didn't quite know what they were playing in the original version, but now I know, so I'm gonna teach you, not my cover version, but I'm gonna teach you the original, but they are pretty close, so it's not too many differences in there. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and have fun playing the song. Okay, so before we start this lesson, we need to talk about two things. The first thing is the tuning. So this is the guitar I use for Miles' part, which is tuned in drop D flat. So you tune your low string, your low E string down to a D, and then you tune the whole guitar down another half step. So you have D flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, B flat, and E flat. And for Mark's part, I use this guitar, which is tuned in double drop D flat, or some people refer to it as double drop D, which is basically the same as the other guitar tuning. So you have the low E string tuned down to a D, but you also have the high E string tuned down to a low, to a E, and then you tune it down a half step. So you have D flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, B flat, and again D flat. So double drop D flat. So the second thing we need to talk about is the picking pattern, which Mark and Miles use to play the intro, the verse, and the pre-chorus, which is a pretty signature Mark Tremonti style 6-8 pattern, which sounds like this. So we are in 6-8 time signature here, and he uses this in many songs, like Water's Rising, for example. Same idea, but a little more complicated. In All Ends Well, it's pretty simple. You always play the eighth notes with your thumb, so that's always, we are in 6th 8th, so 1 2 3 4 5 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6. You always play the eighth notes, and on top of that you layer the other notes with your index finger. So you can practice that by starting off with just one string on your index finger, one string on your thumb, and just practice the timing of it. So then you can build in some string changes, so you can alternate your index finger between the B string and the G string. And then you can try and build in some hammer-ons and pull-offs like he does in the intro riff. So both Miles and Mark use this picking pattern, except for one difference. Mark plays it fingerstyle, so he uses his thumb and index finger. And Mark plays some kind of hybrid picking, so he uses a pick and his ring and middle finger. I really prefer Mark's version with the finger picking, but if you like hybrid picking instead, you can also go for that. I'll play Miles' part with the finger picking. Also, just keep in mind that if you really want to play it like it's played on the original version, he plays his part with the hybrid picking. Let's check out the verse by Mark Tremonti. I'll play it up to speed first. So he plays. So again, he only plays the bass note with the thumb. And on top of that, he plays. So B string, 3 on the B string, 2 on the G string, pull off, hammer on, again B string, and then the high E, or in this case D string. So the next chord progression he plays is this one. So the picking pattern is always the same. It's again bass note with the thumb, and then so B string, G string, E string, and back to the B string. And then he plays for the first chord, it's 4 on the G, 7 on the B, and 5 on the E string. And then you just move everything down and place your ring finger on the 5 again. So from here, you just slide down and put on your ring finger on the 5th fret, and then you have, and together it sounds like this. And then you go back to the original riff. Then you play it twice. Okay. After that, there's another little chord progression which sounds like this. So we start with the 5 on the G string, 8 on the B string, and 7 on the E string. And again, it's the same picking pattern. So we start out B, G, E, B. And then you have a stretch in there. So you have to fret the 4th fret. So you slide down from 5 to 4 on the G string. And then he plays this, which is 8, 7, and 5 on the B string, and a little hammer on, and then the high E string open. And the second time he plays it. And just goes here, and lets it ring out. Okay, let's start with the Miles Kennedy verse up to speed. So you start by putting your index finger on the 7th fret and your pinky on the 10th fret on the B and the E string. So you have something like this. Something like a D chord or D5. And then you just alternate between, so your thumb always plays the bass note and your index finger plays just basically up and down the other two strings. Then you repeat that. Okay, you play that a few times, and then we change chords. So we go from here, which is 0, 7, 10, 10, to 0, 11, 10, 10, then to 0, 10, 10, 10. But this time we also play a hammer-on. This time we play a pull-off on the from the 12 to the 10 on the high E string. So, and then there's this little ending lick that sounds like that. So we only use these two strings, and you play 7, 9, slide up to 11, 9, 7. For the second time, you play it basically the same, but the ending lick changes a little, so it's like this. So instead of playing, you play the 10 on the B string and then go back to the 7. So the second part of the verse you play up here. So you have 0, 12, 13. And you also pull off the 15 to the 13 on the B string. So then you do the same, but this time you lift off your middle finger. So it's a pull off from 15 to 12. So the first time is this. And then you go back to the shape we had before. 0, 11, 10, 10. But this time you play the 14 on the E string at the end. So. And then you play the first part of the second part again. It's just the bass note at the end. Okay, so Mark's pre-chorus part is, in my opinion, the most difficult part of the song. So, up to speed, it sounds like this. We start off by this shape, so 4 on the E string, lower string, 5 on the A string, and 7 on the D string. So you always play the bass note again with the thumb, and the rest is on top of that. The next shape is this. So you can play, or you play 5 on the E string, 9 on the D string, 7 on the G string, and then this is how Mark Tremonti plays it. And if you have big hands like I have, then you can play that, but if you have really small hands, you might have a problem with that. So plays this, so the stretch from your index fingers on the 5 and your pinky is on the 10 up here. If you can't do that, there's another way of playing that. So you can also play, which is probably a little more comfortable for you. So you play, I teach you the first variant first. So either you play, so 9, 7, 10, or you play 9, 7, and 7 on the high E string. That's the second chord. Then we go down to the B chord, which is basically you play 2 on the A string, 4 on the D string, open G string, and 3 on the B string. And just on top of the bass note. And the last chord is this. Something like an A shape or with some diatonic tones between. So, hammer on from 2 to 3. Again 2. That's how you place the last chord. So this is the pre-chorus up to speed. he just uses four chords. The first one is this. So you play four, then you mute the A string. Again, four, two, two. Then you move it up, your ring finger to five, to this G chord. So five, mute, zero, zero, three. Then he plays a B chord with the open strings ringing out on top. So B power chord and open strings. And then he plays an A chord with the fourth finger or the ring finger, sorry, the pinky on the fourth fret of the G string. So you can also mute this string, but it's essentially the same note. So that's the fourth chord. Okay, so what you play here is the same chords as Miles plays in his chorus, which is G, D, and A, but the A chord he plays up here, so it's an A major chord. And from here, so which is 0, 7, 6, 5. And then he plays this little ascending or descending run up here, which is so 11, 12, 14, and then you hit the 7, and then you play, you just start it over again. And you play the same, but instead of this, there is a little lick in between there, which sounds like this. What he plays there is, at least in the first chorus, this is the lick of the first chorus, is so you start off with, you hit 7 two times on the G string, and then you do a half step bend from 6 to 7. So 7, 5, 7, and then you go up there and bend it again. And then you're here. So at the end, there's the same turnaround that Miles plays, which sounds like this. That's the chorus. Okay, so the second chorus and the third chorus have a different lick in between, so they sound like this. So what he plays there is a little hammer-on and pull-off lick. So you start off with your index finger on the 6th fret of the G string. And then there is a little pull off. So you fret 6, 7, and 9, and then you pull it off again. And then you pick 7 and 6 again. Then you pick 9 and 7 on the D string. Then there's another hammer on and pull off. So you just slide down from, you keep your middle finger on the fretboard and just slide down 2 frets. And then just play 5, 4, 7, 5, 4 together, it sounds like this. Okay, so now we are at the chorus. I'll play it up to speed first. So we start out with the G chord. The G chord we already had before, so 5-0-0-3. Then open D5. And an open A chord. We can also let the B string ring out, which is basically an A power chord at 9 or something, but it sounds pretty cool. And you play that 3 times. So on the last time when you hit that, there is a little turnaround which goes like this. So, as usual, G, D, and then you go A power chord like this. Then you play, which is an F sharp first inversion or something. So first fret on the A string and fourth on the D string. And you move it up to the second fret on the B string. So it's and then back to A. And then it's just the normal thing. So we start off by playing 13 on the A string, 15 on the G string, and 13 again on the B string. Then we slide that down to the same shape, but to the 10th fret. And then we play 0 on the D string, 11 on the G, and 10 on the B string. Then we put on the pinky on the 12th fret. Then he repeats that. And then there comes this ascending riff. Same shape as before. Then we go to 14 on the A string, 16 on the G string, and 15 on the B string. Then we go up one fret, so it's 15 on the A string, 17 on the G string, and also 17 on the B string. And we move up another fret to the former shape, which is 16 on the A string, 18 on the G string, and 17 on the B string. So the second part together sounds like this. And then we go into. Okay, so the bridge up to speed sounds like this. Thank you. So we start off by playing a B chord. Just B power chord. And then G chord, played like this. So 5, 5, 5, 7, 8. Okay, and for the last time, you play the bridge part. There is a little ascending part again, which sounds like this. Okay, so this is, we start off at the B chord. Then you play second fret on the A string. And 5th fret on the D string. Then you play a C power chord with just the two strings again. And then you move it up again, same shape. So this time 4 on the A string and 7 on the D string. And then you hit the D5 at the end. And always remember to lift up your arm when you hit that chord, makes it sound better. First chord he plays is 15 on the A string, 17 on the D string, and 19 on the G string. You can also play it like this. Makes it a little easier, because then you can just move your index finger down to 14 and put on your middle finger on the, what is that, 16 on the G string. So from here, you are there. Then you have this octave riff. So we start out by playing 0 on the low E string, 10 on the D, and 12 on the G, and then just slide down. Okay, and this is the outro of All Ends Well Up to Speed. The first one is a C at 9, so 3, 3, then you mute the D string, 0, 3, then you move the note on the A string to the second fret, but the rest stays the same, and then a D chord again for the final chord. So. And that's pretty much the song All Ends Well by Autobitch. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and have fun playing. See you.